Now that we have our loading screen, we are going to create our home screen as we just draw in the drafts. Okay, in this screen we are going to have the current user image, the username, and two buttons, one to go to the contacts list and one to go to the new contact creation. So let's go to our app and create a new screen to accommodate those items. I'm going to go here on tree view, new screen, blank, and that will create the screen number 3 that we are going to rename to home screen. Here in the home screen, we are going to add those elements. First thing is to add the user image. In order to add the user image, we are going to get it dynamically based on the user who is using the app. Every time someone plays the app, it uses the person's Microsoft account, and automatically we can retrieve the name, the email, and the image of that person. So let's go to the app and insert an image. This video is sponsored by the support of my subscribers who like and comment on the videos. This class is part of a full course I have on Udemy where I teach beginners how to build their first apps. So if you want to ensure lifetime access and see the entire course, I suggest you to join me on Udemy. If the course isn't for you, that's okay, but I kindly ask you to show your support by liking this video and subscribe to this channel. Your engagement means a lot to me and motivates me to continue creating valuable content like this. Now, let's get back to the class and continue learning together. Let's click on Insert and find in the classic elements the image. It's here in the media and we have the image element. Once I click here, an empty image will be placed here in the app. It has already a square dimension, 320 by 320. So let's just change the border radius to 180, so it's rounded, as we just draft in our mockup. Now, in order to show the user image, I will select the image, and in the image property of it, I'm going to remove this sample image and put whatever I want here. It could be an image that's uploaded to the app, as we did for the logo, but it can be a formula. This will be our first formula, and we will see that this one will bring the user's image. Right now, the one who is using this app, it's me. We can see we have this image here in the top, and Power Apps recognize that. So let's put this formula, that's the user. User, open and close parentheses, dots, and that will bring the three options I have, image, email, and full name. In this case, I'm bringing the image. So user, open and close parentheses, dots, image. That will bring the user information, the user image. Okay, it's in here already, and depending on who is playing the app, it will show a different picture. Now, let's bring the username. I'm going to insert a label, text label, place it below the image, center it, increase the font size a little, let's say 28. And now, instead of texts in the text property, let's call again the user function. So user, open and close parentheses, dot, and that will show me the three options, and I want to show the full name right now. So dot full name. And that will bring my name, as we have in our mockup. Now let's add the two buttons, Define Contacts and New Contacts. Okay, in order to insert a new button, let's just go to Insert, select the button, and it will bring a button here. Let's just position here below, and then change the text of the button. So here it will be Find Contacts. Let's change the text to Find Contacts. In order to change the text, I selected the button and went here to the right pane and changed the text property of it. We still need to add the second button, but before doing that, I would like to talk and explain more about the element properties and do some adjustments to this button first, So after we are completed, we can just copy from this button and paste the other, so we don't need to do all of the adjustments again. So see you in the next class.